ओके
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। गुड
आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
मैम योर वीडियो इज ऑफ।
यस आई एम स्विचिंग इट ऑफ। फाइन।
यस मैम।
या यू कैन सी मी।
यस मैम।
एमिल, एंथनी, हैरोन, इस्माइल, सनेका, एवरीबॉडी स्विच ऑन योर वीडियोस फास्ट। हैड योर लंच एवरीवन।
यस मैम।
ऑल हेल्दी फ्रेश।
Yes.
Or are you about to sleep now?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So, what are the parts of a flower? Tell me what all you remember from the video.
Sepals, stigma, ovary, ovules.
Then, what is the male reproductive part called?
Stamen.
Okay. So we had the sepals, the petals, stamens,
and
the pistil. These four parts, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And the stigma, style, ovary, ovules of the pistil. Then of the stamens, we learned two parts. What are they? What were they?
Style stigma
ovary was of the pistil. Now what were the parts of a stamen?
Filament and anther.
So you remember everything. I'll just revise through the portion, then we'll do the exercises. With this we finish the chapter, actually parts of a flower. Okay. Yes, see the picture. I hope you all can see the screen, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. So we have the green leaf-like structure called sepals. Then we have the petals. That is the colored part called the petals. Then we have the female reproductive part known as the pistil. Then male reproductive part known as the
stamen.
Stamen. Very good. And we'll have the definitions. I'll send it to you. Don't worry. Whatever you understand, you note down in your lecture note. Okay? I'll send the presentation to your WhatsApp group. Don't worry.
Ma'am, you sent already.
Yeah, I think I sent.
Yeah, ma'am, you sent it.
We already sent. Did we discuss this presentation? No.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, we wrote the definitions.
Have you finished this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, we finished writing this also.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
No problem. Then we'll discuss the exercise questions. Okay? Take out the exercise questions. Just a minute. Take out the textbook.
Page number.
Could you please say the page number?
64.
Thank you.
Okay, fine. Yes, take page number 64.
Okay, ma'am.
Everybody switch on your video. Why are the videos off? Devaganga, I just saw you now. Please mute everyone. Switch on your video instead of your audios, please. Please. Arjun Krishna, Francis, Savio, Sushma Vijayan, who's that?
I'm not in our class.
Ananda Krishna, I think some other person. Who is this with the label Sushma Vijayan? We don't know. Okay, let's not waste our time. So what is the first question? In the first question, the first one, A, option A. Read out, Risa, read out.
Okay, ma'am. Stem absorbs water and minerals from the soil.
Stem absorbs water and minerals from the soil. What is the answer?
False.
Ma'am, it's false.
Everybody agree to that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, then what is the correct answer? Who will tell me?
Roots.
I'll ask. Risa itself, tell the answer, correct answer, correct the statement.
Ma'am, the correct statement is that roots absorb water and minerals from the soil.
Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Everybody make the correction. I'll suggest that you take a pencil and correct it in the textbook itself, and later you can copy down the entire statement.
Ma'am.
Yes, Nihal.
Ma'am, I am in my mother's house, so I did in broad science textbook.
Okay, then you write down the correction in your rough book or notebook. Whichever book you have, you write it down. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
And later, if you have any doubt, you can contact me.
Okay,
fine. Yes. So the first one is roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. That is the correct statement. Roots absorb. Instead of stem, make a correction. It is roots. Okay, roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then the next one, Ashish will read. Ashish, Unni, can you read?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, one leaf.
Leaf hold the plant upright.
Yes, true or false?
False.
False. Then what is the correct answer?
Stem holds the plant upright.
Stem holds the plant upright. Everybody agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Stem holds the plant upright. Correct it. It's not the leaves. It's the stem that holds the plant upright. Stem holds the plant upright. Stem holds the plant upright. Okay. Cut the leaves and write it stem. Stem holds the plant upright. Now 1C. Nihal Mustafa, you can read. Oh, sorry. You don't have the textbook, no? Geetika, will you read?
Roots conduct water to the leaves.
Roots conduct water to the leaves. What is the statement correct or not? Geetika?
No, ma'am.
What is the correct. Yeah, it is false. Then what is the correct answer?
Stems conduct water to the leaves.
Yes. Anybody who disagrees with that?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. No, ma'am. So that is the correct answer. Stem conduct water to the leaves. Stem conduct water to the leaves. Amita, Anthony, Ayan, Kanish, Kanandakrishnan, Vinayak, then who's this? Savio, Francis, Malavika. Switch on your video.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is second question's answer?
Ma'am, stem holds the plant.
Stem holds the plant upright.
Stem holds the plant.
Yeah, what was the question? I didn't hear. Second one. Is it
the leaves hold the plant upright?
The correct statement is stem holds the plant upright. Now, the fourth one. Devaganga will read. Fourth one. Okay, Ananda Krishnan, I saw the message. Devaganga, read the fourth one, please. Where is Devaganga? Network issue. Okay, then Atul. Atul, can you read the fourth one? 1D. The number of petals. That one. Please unmute. Unmute, dear. Yeah. Atul. Atul. What happened? Atul, are you there? Your eyes are blinking. I can see you.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Can you read the fourth one?
My textbook is not here, ma'am.
Okay. What happened to everybody's textbook? Sanaika, read the fourth one.
Yes, ma'am.
Read the fourth one. Come on. The number of...
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.
Tells and... stamens in a flower is always equal.
Okay. Is it true or false?
False.
False. Then what is the correct statement?
The number of petals and stamens in a flower is not always equal.
Okay. You can correct it as may not be always equal. May not be always equal. I'll read the full statement once more. The number of petals and stamens in a flower may not be always equal.
Me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can the sepals and petals be same in a flower?
Sepals and petals be same.
No, ma'am. Number of petals.
Same number of petals and sepals. May or may not be. It's not always possible. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
So, may not be always equal. That is the correction that you have to make. In the statement in the textbook, it is given they are always equal. That is, in a flower is always equal. You have to write may not be always equal. Okay. Now, the next statement, D. Sorry, E. Savio will read. E, statement E. Savio. Where is Savio? Gone. Aaron Anthony, can you read statement E?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
If the sepals of a flower are joined together,
yes,
its petals are also joined together.
Okay, if the sepals are joined together, your textbook is telling the petals are also joined together. Is it true or false, Anthony? Aaron Anthony, sorry.
Ma'am, that is not the question, ma'am.
Which is the one then?
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, you are saying about E, right?
E, yes. We are discussing E. Yes, Aaron. Is it true or false?
False.
False. Then what is the correct answer?
They will not join.
Yes. If I'll read out the correct statement, please note down. If the sepals of a flower are joined together, its petals are separate. Petals are separate. That's the correction you have to make. Petals are separate. Sirudra, Shravana, Savio, Namastya, then Malavika, Ayan, Muhammad, what happened to your video?
Ma'am, are you saying separate or some other word?
Separate. The petals are separate. That is the correction you have to make. Petals are, in textbook it is joined, but you have to correct it into separate. The petals are separate. Okay. S-E-P-A-R-A-T-E. Separate. To separate. Okay. Fine. Now the next one. Next one. Savio, are you ready to read? Yes. Unmute.
Ma'am, F.
Okay. You can read the next one. F. Statement F.
If the petals of a flower are joined together,
yes,
then the pistil is joined to the petal.
Okay, true or false? What do you think? Read it once more and see. Find it if it is true or not.
Question
mudiyum
mudivare.
Do you know? Any guess? Any wild guess?
True.
No, it's false. Okay, I'll correct the statement. Note down. If the petals of a flower join together, then the pistil may or may not be joined to the petal. And the pistil may or may not be. You have to make that correction. May or may not be joined to the petal. May or may not be joined to the petal. Finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see once again?
Yes, I'll repeat. If the petals of a flower join together, then the pistil may or may not be joined to the petal. From the statement given in your textbook, you just have to make a single correction. May or may not be joined to the petal. Okay? Fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? No, ma'am. Okay. Now the next question. Question number two is draw. We have to draw some things. So the first one is a leaf, which we already have. I have sent you over the picture. Then you have the taproot. Then you have a flower. I hope you know to draw them and label the parts, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So you can draw them and send it over to me as the homework.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So you have to draw a leaf and you have to label all the parts that you have studied. Then you have to draw a root, that is a taproot. Sorry, not a root. Taproots in specific. Then you have to draw a flower and label its parts. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Can you do that? Yes, ma'am.
Everybody, only Devika is answering.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Somebody is asking a doubt.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it Anandakrishnan? Was that you?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Ah. Yes, Ananya. Ah. Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, should we draw the root and label it?
Yeah, taproot, you can label it. The main root and the lateral roots. Yes? Fine. The next question. Can you find a plant in your house or in your neighborhood? Listen carefully. Can you find a plant in your house or in your neighborhood which has a long but weak stem? Which has a long but weak stem? Write its name. In which category will you place it? Do you know any plant which has a long but
yes, ma'am.
Weak stem? Yes.
Neem.
Neem. Neem has a strong stem.
Yes, ma'am. Neem has strong stem.
Ma'am, money plant.
Money plant. Honey plant. That is a
money plant. Yes.
Money plant. Then.
Ma'am, passion.
Ma'am, some kind of
passion fruit. Yes. Then.
Some creepers.
Creepers. Yes.
Like the pumpkin.
Belong to the category creepers. Write
ma'am,
down.
Mulberry.
Yes. Write down. Write ma'am. Down. Mulberry is a bush, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. But its stem is weak.
But we are talking about a long like a and weak stem. Very long and weak stem. So you can put it in the category of creepers.
Ma'am.
Write down creepers. C-R-E-E-P-E-R-S. Creepers. Okay. An example you can write. Pumpkin, watermelon, all that. Fine. Oh, I'm happy. Everybody's videos saw what happened. Except Namasya and Amita. Today's a good day for me, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
I don't have to shout to switch on video. Yeah. The next question. What is the function of a stem? I will ask Spruti. Tell me, what are the functions of a stem?
Ma'am, our first function, the stem helps to hold the plant.
Wait, just a minute. Everybody listen. I won't repeat the answer or else we'll lose more time. Yes, Smriti, the first function is?
Function is the stem helps to hold the plant upright.
Stem helps to hold the plant upright. Listen. Yes, then.
Second function is the stem helps to, transport minerals and water
yes.
from the root to leaves and from the leaves to other plants. Parts of the plant.
Water and minerals. Transportation of water and minerals. Then?
Ma'am, then the stem, it holds all the parts of the plant.
It bears all the parts of the plant. Yes, then?
Ma'am, I think
one more function.
Ma'am, it absorbs yes, all the nutrients from the soil.
Ah, that is root. Root absorbs water and
minerals. It also carries food prepared in leaves to different yes. parts of the plant through phloem,
yes, that's the point. Mama, I'm looking. You told about water and ma'am. Minerals. You didn't tell about food.
Ma'am, okay. Ma'am has
two types of food.
From root to leaves and from leaves to other parts of plant.
Yes, but you told that stems conduct water and minerals. You didn't mention the food. I was looking for that particular word, food. Very good, Smriti and Devika.
Thank you.
You have provided the portion very well. Yes, so. What are the functions? Who will repeat? Harriet, can you repeat? Functions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, it holds the plants upright.
Yes.
Then it transport the water and minerals.
Transport the water and minerals. That is another function. Then third function.
Then it transports food.
Transports food. That is another function. One more function.
One more point.
The stem bears the. Stem bears the. Just now we discussed stem bears the other parts. Remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Devika, what was the point?
Stem bears the leaves, fruits, flowers,
buds, etc. Okay, everybody. Third, the stem bears the roots. Sorry, not the roots. The fruits, the flowers, the leaves, the buds, etc.
Yes.
Okay, so there are basically four functions. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we'll move on to the next question. Who can read the question? Sravana Suresh, you can read the next question. Question number 5.
Okay, ma'am. Which of the following leaves have reticulate venation?
Okay. Wheat. Just read the options. I'll just share the screen. You can read the options.
Okay, ma'am. Wheat. Tulsi. Maize. Grass. Coriander. China rose.
Okay. Yeah, I hope you all can see the screen, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, the question is, which of the following leaves have reticulate venation? So, when we discuss, if you think the plant has a reticulate venation, then mark an R there. And if you think that it has a parallel venation, mark a P there. In the text.
Okay, ma'am.
Fine. So, this is the first one. Sorry, I didn't hear.
Tulsi has a reticulate venation, right?
Wait. We are discussing one by one. We'll start with the first one. What is the first one, Risa?
It's wheat.
Wheat. Wheat. Which venation do you think? This is the picture of the wheat plant.
Parallel venation.
Parallel venation. So mark a P there. Mark a P. Mark, underline wheat and mark a P there.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Which is the next one? Harriet? Harriet, which is the next one?
Tulsi.
Tulsi, yes. Tulsi, I'll show the tulsi leaf. Yes, wait. I'll ask. Wait. Abhinav Sajan, are you there? Abhinav?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, which venation is this?
Ma'am,
yes?
Reticulate.
Yes, it is reticulate venation. So mark R. Tulsi has a reticulate venation. Now, which is the next option? Emil, read out from the textbook. Which is the next one after Tulsi?
Maize.
Yes, I'll show you the maize. This is the maize leaf. Emil, which is the venation here?
Parallel.
Parallel venation. Very good. Everybody, mark a P there. Parallel venation. Maize has a parallel venation. Now, the next one. Malavika Bini. Read the next one after the maize. Malavika. Network again. Anthony Vito. Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Anthony, yes. Read the next one after the maize.
Grass.
I'll show you the grass. Yeah. Grass has which venation, Anthony? See the
parallel picture? Venation.
Yes, parallel venation. So mark P. Parallel venation. Now, Abhyuday. Abhyuday, read the next one after the grass.
Coriander.
Coriander, we use it for cooking, no? Moms use it for cooking. This coriander leaf. Do you like coriander? The flavor of coriander?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I hate it. Okay, yeah. Yes, Abhyuday, tell me which venation is this?
Reticulate venation.
Reticulate venation. Correct answer. Very good. So mark R there. Coriander has reticulate venation. Then China rose. Hibiscus is also known as China rose. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And last day, we saw the picture of another type of rose. No? I showed you small roses.
Yes, ma'am.
Remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that is also a variety of rose. That is Chinese rose. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
China rose as such is hibiscus.
Yes, ma'am. I was having a doubt on what is a China rose, because it is told rose, right? Yes, so when I typed it in Google, it showed hibiscus.
Hibiscus.
So below that itself, it showed Chinese rose also. That is rose itself, but another one specialty of color and one Pickle design also.
Yes,
ma'am.
Very good.
And so, ma'am, so hibiscus has a lot of names.
Hibiscus has a lot of names. It is known as shoe flower. It is known as China rose. It is known as hibiscus. And in different languages also, we have different names for hibiscus. So back to our portion. So this is the China rose flower and the China rose plant. Which venation does it have?
Another reticulate
venation. So mark R there. Now, who will tell me? Devika, tell me. So out of all these options, which are the ones having reticulate?
Tulsi.
Everybody check your answers. Tulsi.
Coriander. And China rose.
Tulsi, coriander and China rose have reticulate venation. Yes, very good. Now, who will read the next question? Altina, read the next question.
If a plant has fibrous root, what type of venation do it leaves have?
If a plant has fibrous root, what type of venation do its leaves have? Now, before you find the answer, let me ask you, give me an example of a plant with fibrous root. A common example that we learned.
Ma'am,
grass.
Yes, grass. I'll show you the picture. I already showed you, but once more I show you. This is the picture of the grass plant. Okay, yes, what type of venation does it have?
Parallel venation.
Note that in your lecture note, if a plant has a fibrous root, then it has what type of venation?
Parallel venation.
If you get any confusion, remember about our grass. Okay, this is something that you see daily, no?
Yes, ma'am. But plants are the plants with fibrous root have a reticulate venation also, right?
No, most of the plants with fibrous root have parallel venation. That's how we find out. If we see a plant with parallel venation, then we can know that under the ground, inside the soil, we have a fibrous root. Okay. Yes. Clear? Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So note down. The answer is parallel venation. If a plant has fibrous root, what type of venation do its leaves have? Parallel venation. Okay. Next question. Anna, read. Read the next question.
If a plant has leaves with reticulate venation, what kind of roots will it have?
Okay, that's just the opposite of what we discussed right now. What do you think, Anna? What is the answer?
Reticulate venation.
Yeah, reticulate venation, and the root will be?
Taproot.
Taproot, very good. So the plants which have reticulate venation on the leaves will have taproot. Okay, that was the seventh question. Now we'll move on to the eighth one. Okay. Eighth question is it possible for you to find out whether a plant has taproot or fibrous root by looking at the impression of its leaf on a sheet of paper? We already did this activity, no? Remember?
Yeah,
it was the homework for you all, and you sent me beautiful shadings and pictures of leaves with parallel venation as well as reticulate venation. Now,
ma'am, can you see the answer of seventh question?
Sorry?
Ma'am, can you see the answer of seventh question?
Yeah, you tell me what is the answer of seventh question. Read the seventh question once more.
A plant has leaves with a reticulate venation. What kind of root does it have?
Yes, what do you think is the answer? We just discussed that now. Sorry, I didn't hear.
Ma'am, I think it's reticulate venation.
Reticulate venation, yes, that is correct. Reticulate venation has what type of root? If parallel venation has fibrous root, then reticulate venation will have? We'll have. Who's the person asking? I can't see the face.
I think so. It's Ananya Kivijish.
Yes, Ananya.
Ma'am, is it taproot?
Yes, taproot. It is taproot. So again, I'll clear it once more. The remember the grass plant. It has a parallel venation and it has a fibrous. Mm-hmm. For both of the things, we have learned the example as grass. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So it has a fibrous root as well as a parallel venation. So obviously, the plants with parallel venation will have a fibrous root. The plants with fibrous root will have a parallel venation. You have to make that very clear. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Then the opposite will be parallel venation's opposite. What is it? Reticulate venation. Then fibrous root opposite is?
Taproot.
So reticulate venation, the plants which have reticulate venation on the leaves, they'll have taproot. Clear, Ananya? Did she leave? I can't see her. Ananya, is it clear? I think she has some network issue. Okay, we'll move on.
Yes. I'm here.
Yes. Very good, Ananya. Then, yes. 8th question, can anybody read it for me? Smriti, can you read it? 8th question. I already read it once. Smriti, can you read the 8th question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Is it possible for you to find out whether a plant has taproot or fibrous roots by looking at the impression of its leaf on a sheet of paper?
Okay. What do you think is the answer?
Yes.
Yes. Why? Or how?
Because when we take the shade impression of the leaf on a sheet of paper,
yes,
we can know what type of venation it has. And yes, we can understand the type of root from the venation.
Very good. Very, very good. That's an excellent answer. Yes, Geetika, you tell me. Smriti just told that from the venation we can understand. How will we understand? You have imagine that you have a leaf impression with parallel venation and one with reticulate venation. How will you understand the type of root?
If it has parallel venation, the root will be fibrous.
Yes.
If it has a reticulate venation, then it will have a taproot.
Excellent. Very good. Very good. So I hope you have understood that concept very well. Yes?
We
have discussed so many examples. Yes. Very good. Now the next question is, what are the parts of a flower? That's a very simple question. I will ask to who hasn't answered? Sian Fatima, can you answer? And Fatima, what are the parts of a flower that we learn? Parts of a flower.
Sepals,
yes.
Petals,
yes. Then the male and female. Stamens, yes. Then?
Pistil,
very good. That's it. Anybody has a doubt in that?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
Then I want, who will read the next question? Who hasn't got a chance yet? Ayan Muhammad, read out the 10th question.
From the following plants, which of them have flowers?
Flowers, yes. Grass, do you think they have flowers, Ayan? No, okay, fine. Arjun Krishna, the next one, maize. Maize, do maize plants have flowers?
No.
No. Okay. Very good. Then wheat. Ismail Suhim. Wheat. Does that have a flower?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Pruthi.
Ma'am, for this maize, wheat, and rice, and all, there is a small flower, and the grains come from that flower, right?
No. I'll show the picture once. They are not the flowers exactly. We are talking about the flower, the parts of a flower and the exact structure of a flower we learn, no? We are looking for that. Do you see any flower in this?
No, ma'am.
No. The grains, those particles look like flowers, but they are not flowers. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Then, next one is chili. Have you ever seen a chili plant? Anybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then tell me, do they have flowers?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. They have very beautiful white flowers.
White flowers.
See? Beautiful, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Chili flowers are really beautiful.
And we have chili growing, small one.
Uh-huh, very good.
In our mother's house, there is chili.
Ah, very good, very good. In my house also, at Ernakulam, we also have
it. Ma'am, yes, ma'am, here it is. The
plant a lot of chili in my house.
Yeah, very good.
Ma'am, okay, so many colors are there, ma'am. Purple color chili.
Yeah, purple color also is there. Okay, but most commonly we see white flowers for chili. Okay, so yes, circle ma'am. The chili and keep in the textbook. Chili has a flower. Circle the chili, everyone. Okay. Then we have tomato. Tomato also has a flower. Mark that.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, and the rest we'll continue in the next class. I'll take the attendance now. Just a minute.
Okay, ma'am.
Class is still 2:20, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Just a minute. Okay, I'll just call out the attendance. Aaron Anthony?
Present, ma'am.
Yes. Then Abhinav Sajan?
Present, ma'am.
Abhyuday? Present.
Present, ma'am.
Alcina? Present. Ameya? Ameya, I didn't see Ameya. Absent. Devika, please help me with the absentees. Amita? Okay. Amita is present. Ananya Jinto? Present. Anandakrishnan? Present. Ananya K. Vijesh? Present. Anna? Present. Anthony Vijo? Present. Arjun Krishna is present, no?
Yes, ma'am. He was yes. there.
Ashishumni? Present. Atul? Atul.
Present, ma'am.
Present.
He was present.
Okay. Ayan is present. Ayush, present.
Yes,
Devaganga is present. Devika is present. Namasya, present. Emil, present. Francis, Geetika, Harriet. Then Haya, present?
No, ma'am.
She's absent.
No, ma'am. She's
Ismail, absent. Ismail is present, no?
Yes,
was
ma'am.
Present, yes. Kanishk, yes. Malavika, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Nihal, yes. Saneka, Savio, Sian, Fatima, Smriti, Shravana is present, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes. Sri Rudra, present.
No, ma'am. She's absent.
She was present, no?
No, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Vinayak, present. He came in between, I saw. Brisa also present. Okay, yes, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Find out the answer will come, okay, for the rest of the question.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye.